In the next few months, a star thousands of light years away will explode with such intensity that you can witness it with your own eyes, no telescope needed. It's a rare cosmic event that's not only beautiful, but also a scientific gold mine. By studying this exploding star, we might learn more about how life began and uncover secrets about the mysterious forces shaping our universe. But before we go any further, let's get to know the star that's going to give us the incredible light show. It's called T. Coronae Borealis, or TCRB for short. And it's not your ordinary run-of-the-mill star. It's actually two stars, kind of like an old married couple circling each other out in space. One of the stars is a white dwarf, basically a star that's burned out and retired. The other is a red giant, a much bigger star nearing the end of its life. The white dwarf is super dense and has incredibly strong gravity. This gravity acts like a vacuum, sucking in gas from its red giant companion. That gas starts piling up on the surface of the white dwarf. As more and more gas gets added, the pressure and temperature in that layer of gas keep rising. Eventually, all that stuff piled up on the white dwarf creates intense pressure. This pressure builds and builds until, boom! The massive explosion blasts outward, making the star system thousands of times brighter than usual. This explosion is what we call a nova. Astronomers have been watching TCRB for over a century, and they've noticed a really cool pattern. Every 80 years or so, like clockwork, this star system has a massive explosion. The first one we know of was spotted back in 1866, and then again in 1846, and scientists even think a German monk might have seen it way back in 1217. Each explosion is like a cosmic time capsule, giving us a glimpse into the same event happening over and over again. But I know what you're thinking, why this 80-year cycle? Well, it's about the balance between that greedy white dwarf and its red giant companion. You see, it takes time for the white dwarf to slurp up enough gas from the red giant to trigger the explosion. It's a slow process, like filling a bathtub with a slow drip. It takes around 80 years for the white dwarf to collect enough material to reach that critical point. And that tipping point is where the pressure and heat become too much and boom, the nova explosion happens. But why did the explosion not completely destroy the star? Well, this explosion is pretty powerful, but it's not strong enough to destroy the entire star system. That's because a nova is different from a supernova. In a supernova, the star is completely destroyed. But these novas are like a safety valve on a giant pressure cooker. If you don't let the steam out, it'll explode. But if you have a little whistle that lets out steam at regular intervals, it keeps everything under control. In TCRB, the nova is like that whistle. It lets out a big burst of energy, releasing the pressure before it gets too high to destroy everything. This is why the star system doesn't get completely blown apart, and why it repeats the cycle every 80 years or so. Okay, so why should we care about a star exploding thousands of light years away? Well, this star, T. Coronae Borealis, is doing something pretty amazing. These explosions are actually creating super important elements like carbon, nitrogen, and oxygen. You might be thinking, so what? Well, those are the building blocks of life itself. The carbon in our bodies, the nitrogen we breathe, and the oxygen that keeps us alive all originated from stars like TCRB. So, by studying these explosions, scientists learn how these life-giving elements were made and how they spread throughout the universe. It's like discovering a hidden recipe for the cosmos itself. So even though TCRB is far away, its explosions have a direct connection to us here on Earth. And that's not all. TCRB might also help us solve one of the biggest mysteries in astronomy, dark energy. This invisible force is making the universe expand faster and faster, but scientists don't really know what it is. So, TCRB's explosion could be a key piece of the puzzle, helping us figure out what dark energy is and how it works. And because TCRB explodes so predictably, scientists can plan and prepare for this event. They'll have telescopes trained on it, collecting data and measuring every tiny change in brightness. This kind of research wouldn't be possible if TCRB was just your average unpredictable star. Its regular explosions make it a perfect natural laboratory for studying some of the most fundamental questions about the universe. Plus, it's a humbling reminder that we're all part of something much bigger. A vast and complex universe that's constantly revolving and changing. And that's why TCRB isn't just another star explosion. It's a rare opportunity for discovery and a testament to the interconnectedness of everything in the cosmos. Okay, now for the exciting part, how you can witness this incredible cosmic event. The good news is, you don't need fancy equipment or a degree in astrophysics. In fact, all you really need are your own eyes and a little bit of know-how. First things first, you need to find the right spot in the sky. T. Coronae Borealis lives in the Northern Crown constellation. But don't worry if you're not an expert stargazer, this constellation is actually pretty easy to find. Look for a semicircle of stars that looks like a crown or tiara. It's located in the northern hemisphere, so make sure you're facing the right way. If you have trouble finding it, there are plenty of stargazing apps and websites that can help you locate the constellation. But maybe you're thinking, when to look? Well, astronomers predict that TCRB will reach peak brightness sometime between now and September 2024. But the truth is, nobody knows exactly when it will happen. That's part of the excitement, buddy. TCRB is a bit unpredictable, which means we have to keep our eyes peeled. And when TCRB explodes, it will brighten dramatically. It's expected to become visible to the naked eye, so you won't need a telescope or binoculars to see it. It won't look like a giant fireball or anything. It looks more like a bright star that suddenly appears in the constellation. This peak brightness will last for a few days, so you'll have a few nights to catch the show. But don't wait too long. After the initial outburst, TCRB will start to fade again, becoming dimmer and harder to see. Watching TCRB explode isn't just about seeing a pretty light in the sky. It's about witnessing a rare cosmic event, something that most people will never get to see. It's a reminder of the vastness and wonder of the universe, and a chance to connect with the scientific discoveries that are happening all around us. So, mark your calendars, find a dark spot, and get ready for the celestial fireworks show of a lifetime.